organize this program, to organize this gathering, I should say. Perhaps if Madhukar were alive, as we all know him, he would be hesitant to be a part of any function which remembers him or which looks up to him. But I think those of us who had association with him, we can't help ourselves but to organize such a gathering, because it's an occasion to share some of the, and listen and maybe revive some of those memories which always inspired all of us. So I'm thankful to the people who took initiative to organize, thankful to invite me also for this gathering. As SP in the beginning, she was saying that she didn't have an opportunity to work with him. I was, I think, that way very lucky. I find myself very fortunate that I got opportunity to work with him, then have friendship with him. Maybe not the friendship of the college level, what Arun Chakravarti Saab had. He was more fortunate. But I worked with him in 2-3 places, and then that relation what we developed during that working in those 2-3 places, that continued. Because he had such a personality that even if once you interact with him, you would like to go back to him for something. Any, I remember I will discuss with him something totally unconnected issues also. Generally, when DC and SP in a district meet together, they will discuss some issues like police type, what are the things. But I used to sometimes discuss with him totally unconnected, like in Chikmagalur, once we were thinking how to promote tourism. So I discussed with him once that what is it. So he had a completely different, I realized, completely different perspective of looking at things. How it came from a unique blend of intellect, compassion. For tourism, he said, he was just 1 year junior to me, but out of so much respect, he will call me always sir. And sometimes he will give the police salute. He is 6'3", I am not even 6. I will say that, why are you embarrassing me? It doesn't look nice. But he will do everything in the proper way, whatever we all know him. So in that, for the tourism thing, he said, sir, generally tourism is looked at upon as if it's a big hotel industry, airport and all that. So in that, it gets lost in big money-making thing. And the local population who should benefit by tourism, they get neglected. So we should, for a place like Chikmagalur, perhaps we should focus more on this homestays. So this was as far as back as 2004. At that time, this homestay concept in Chikmagalur at least had not started. Perhaps in Kodgu, little bit it had picked up. So he gave this idea, and that really it struck me that how, you know, we just for the sake of it that everybody is promoting tourism, let us promote tourism. We forget what is the purpose of promoting tourism. It should benefit the local people. So he had this different kind of perspective I gained whenever I interacted with him on every issue. Even, I don't know, Bidar thing also Ahad mentioned. So whatever Bidar, you know, little bit, all that, I think the foundational thought in my mind came from one of the interactions with him. We were in Chikmagalur and one main road was widened. And we were going once, and then some people came that our houses are demolished, some other type of complaints were there. This was, this road widening was done by my predecessor. And I had gone after that there. So one of the evening we were sitting and we were chatting. And then he told me, sir, why is it that when we are doing something road widening, which is for the benefit of the people, Why is it we are not able to convince people? Why is it we can't have a situation that people only ask us to widen, people only invite us to widen, and it's like they welcome us for road widening? So at that time, suddenly, because you have widening means demolition, bulldozer, JCB, in that how do you get these people support and all, suddenly it looked like that. But then after a period when I contemplated on it, and somehow I got the opportunity to sort of implement that idea what he gave me in my mind in Bidar, where of course wonderful people are there. Without people's support, it would not have been possible. But something I think what he had in his vision, something like that we could achieve. Because one of the roads, when I went once to widen, this was a commercial road, and we had told the traders, we will come to you before widening and then we'll come and talk to you. So I had given some time on the 5 ಗಂಟೆ ಸುಮಾರು ಟೈಮ್ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ನಾವು ಬರ್ತೇವೆ ಅಂತ. ನಾನು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗೋಕ್ಕೆ 9 ಗಂಟೆ ಆಯಿತು ರಾತ್ರಿ ಅವ್ರ ಹತ್ತಿರ. ಆದರೂ ಸಹ ಅವರು ಎಲ್ಲ ಜನ ಸೇರಿ ಅವರು ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒಂದು ದೇ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಗಾರ್ಲೆಂಡ್ ಟು ವಿತ್ ಗಾರ್ಲೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಐ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ದೆನ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಜೋಕಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್, ನೀವು ಎಂಥ ಜನ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಂಗಡಿ ಡೆಮೊಲಿಷ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಿ, ನೀವು ಈ ರೀತಿ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ. ಬಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಮಧುಕರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಪುಟ್ ದಟ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ. So, Bhavishaya, at that time, that idea remained in my mind that when we are doing, how do we associate, how do we convince people, it is for your betterment. And when people, avaru convince adru, idu namma betterment ge ide, avaga matra avaru nam jothege adannu munde bandru. So, Bhavishaya, nanu avarige yavattu ondu police officer anta nodle illa, ondu yavudo vishayadalli avardu bere, it was a joy to interact with him. I feel sometimes now, ನಾನು ಇನ್ನೂ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು. ಐ ಮಿಸ್ಡ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುನೋ ವೆನ್ ಐ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಮ್, ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವಟ್ ಡೂ ಐ ಯುನೋ ವಟ್ ಡೂ ವಿ ಸೇ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಯುನೋ ಐ ಕುಡ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕರೇಜ್. ಅಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ನೋ ಹೌ ಕರೇಜಿಯಸ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾಷನ್, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾಷನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಗೇವ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಎ different perspective to look at everything in a different way. And of course, character, you know, some of the things we take as if routine ide, idar bagge yake chintane maadbeku. I would like to share one just small anecdote. He was posted as ADC to governor, and in that post he is required to stand for long hours in the formal ceremonies behind the governor. And at that time, he developed back sciatic pain, I think doctors call it. And so some backbone was getting pressed, and then his one leg will get numb. So I had little exposure because my brother-in-law is some orthopedic surgeon. So sometimes I talk to him. So when he told me that my leg is getting numb, I said, it's a very serious matter. Leg is getting numb means it is ಯಾವುದು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಗೆ ಸೀರಿಯಸ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ರಜಾ ತಗೊಂಡು ಒಂದು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಬಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಈ ಸೆಟ್ ಸಟ್ ಸೊ ಹೀ ಸೆಟ್ ದಟ್ ಸಮ್ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅನ್ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಲೀವ್ ನಾವ್ ಆನ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಟೇಕ್. ಸೊ he labored on with that pain for 5-6 months. It was, in fact, I used to sometimes feel very odd, why is he doing? But you know, the kind of character what we are saying, or kind of value what he stood for, some of the things you will feel that it is impractical, but if you realize that is the right thing only, if you think in a situation, what should one person do, what should one person think and say, he will say the most appropriate thing and in a most simple manner. But yes, many a time we felt it is impractical. Just I'll finish so many things, but I have got this opportunity. So many times I, you know, discuss one-to-one basis with some people, but I would like to share just one example of courage of him. He was with me in Chamarajanagar, then he took a voluntary transfer and he joined STF, this anti-Veerappan task force. So one day after 2-3 months when he had joined, I thought, let me go and see where does he. So STF camp used to be secretive location. It is not that you will come to know. So he said, sir, you stay at one place. I'll only come and pick you up. So he came. I was in my vehicle, and in Chamarajanagar those days, red light not used to be there, because once you enter those MM Hill forest, if you are going in a red light, you are target number one. So anyway, I went there, and then he came driving one Tata Sumo. On his own he was driving, and he made me sit, and then he drove for a few kilometers. He went. And I was asking him that, hinge illi kelta irteve ee turn alli avaru aa rite shoot madidru avrige nimge hinge neevu obbre olaartta iddira neevu sp stf you must be the target number 1 neevu hinge obbre olaartta iddiri. So no sir, I have kept I think 1 or 2 AK-47 in the vehicle, but you are alone and you should be walking with the protection. So something he said, which really moved me, he said, it's thousands of kilometer, square kilometer of forest area. To search him, it is so difficult. Perhaps if he sees me moving around alone, he will at least come to attack me, and then at least I will get an opportunity to attack him. I was, really shocked that, you are moving like a live, bait. This is, and... of course, when so there are innumerable such circumstances and innumerable such instances. Each of us, whoever has associated, have lovely memories. And I'm once again, I hope that sometimes I feel that people who have not worked with him or seen him, how do you convince him that such a person, because worked really in our government service, because once we look around, many a times when we look around, not once, many a times we feel pessimistic and sort of cynical about the way things are. But here there was a person, you look at him and he will inspire hope in you, hope in humanity, hope in the goodness of things, hope in all good things what we ನಾವು ಏನು ಕೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ಈ ಥರದ್ದು ಇರಬೇಕು, ಆ ಥರ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಹೀಗೆ ಐಡಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಹೀಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಅದು ಯಾಕೆ ಇರಬೇಕು ಈ ಕೆಲವು ಸರ್ತಿ ನೋಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕ್ಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬಟ್ ಅಂಥವರು ಹಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ರಿಯಲಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೈರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಚೀವೇಬಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ ಶುಡ್ ವಿ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಸಚ್ ಗ್ಯಾದರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಗಿವ್ ಎನ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಟು other people also to, those who were not so, I'll say, fortunate enough, because it was really fortunate to know such a person. And it will, I hope and I'm sure this such gatherings and such efforts will inspire, will apprise more and more people about what he was, and in that way inspire all of us to do our own bit for the, not only for the service, for the society. And just last thing I would say and an end that, not only in service he was good, but as a human being I felt he was. What he was in person, he behaved in service. Once I was asking him that, somebody is advising that, why do you work with so much passion? Sincerity is enough. Why to have passion? With that passion, then what happens is, you do something and you are not able to do, then you feel bad. Why can't we dissociate passion and be sincere enough? That should be good enough. So that was, I was really debating that. Somebody really advised me, and then he said, sir, it is like, as I'm giving an example, that what he was in personal life, he was in as an officer. So he said, passion is not like some, shirt which you can change when you come from office. If you go to office, you wear some other shirt which is not passionless, and when you come back, you wear something which is, you wear your passion if it is. So he had a way of, I would say, as a friend, I remember him more, that way of explaining, and so many things, so many times confuse us. But he had a way of explaining those things in such a beautiful and correct, appropriate manner. I think I have taken a lot of time. I once again thank all of you for inviting me, for remembering to invite me and giving me an opportunity to share some of my thoughts with you. Thanks a lot.